Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to another episode of the Penalty Box with your host, Kalal Oakman. I've been away for quite a while, and let's just put it this way. The shit has hit the fan. First and foremost, the rumors behind my disappearance. No, I wasn't in the hospital for multiple personality disorder. I was in anger management classes. Yeah, that's one of those things we agreed with the league that I'd do to make sure I don't drop any more fucking Effenheimers. That's a freebie. I'll let that slide. What? Anyways, a lot's been going on in the VHL in my absence. There's been a lot of fantastic hockey. Season 5 has been spectacular. A lot of offense. A lot of strange stories. Last season, Season 4, the Beasts were in the East. And the rest of the best, or the best of the rest, was in the West. Not this season. It's looking like the best is in the West, and the rest is in the East. Be that as it may, there are some stories in both sides in the VHL right now that are quite interesting. We're going to start things off with a little bit of the Pittsburgh Penguins in peril? Seriously, what is wrong with this season's Pittsburgh Penguins? I mean, they are only, 16 points out of first place? Usually a top contender, last season's President's Trophy winner, defending Stanley Cup champion from season 3. 16 points out of first place? I mean, the New York Islanders are hot, don't get me wrong. They're a fantastic team when they play on their French Connection. This has to be the first time in VHL history that Smirky, the owner of the Pittsburgh Penguins, I wouldn't say VHL history, I'd say the first time in his VHL owner career, that his team has struggled as much as they have this season. I mean, seriously, at one point, they went, 2-6-1 1 week? When was the last time you heard about the Penguins losing 6 games in 1 week? We're talking about a team that had, 20-something game winning streak last season. You have two all-star goaltenders. See what I have to put up with here? You were supposed to be being babysat by Sam. When did they send you? So he sent that too? Forgive the mascot. He doesn't know his own place. He's fun, he's lovable, he's cute. Helps with the anger. I mean, he's so fluffy and cute, you can't really get angry at that guy. I can about other people in the league, but we'll get to that in a second. Anyways, the Pittsburgh Penguins, as I was saying. 2-6-1 1 week. Last week, they turned the ship around, made some trades. Right now, they're currently riding a 5-game winning streak. I'm not saying that all is lost in Pittsburgh Penguin land. I'm just saying something strange. This is not the same team that we have seen the last 2 seasons. I mean, despite the 5-game winning streak, this season's Pens are nowhere near what the previous Penguins of 2 seasons past have been. Trailing your division leader by 16 points, not even in contention for the President's Trophy. Yeah, you're clinging on to 4th place right now, but you've been jockeying between 6th and 4th in the whole playoff bracket type of thing. It's not over. It's still mid-season. You can still make that killer trade or right this ship. Don't get me wrong, Pittsburgh Penguin fans. I'm not bashing your team. I'm just saying, what the hell? But here's the one thing that really scratches my head. You trade Hot Rivet, who had 10 victories this season. Hot Rivet. The hot goaltender, the rookie goaltender last season. That helped you win that President's Trophy. That got you within 1 game of the Stanley Cup Finals. As my cat goes leaping across the desk, trying to chase that stinking... What the hell was that? We'll edit that out. You trade Hot Rivet. You get a guy named Miami. Miami's doing pretty good. He's 4-1. Change of scenery probably help, but I don't understand why you would change the hot hand and hot rivet and you keep Smarts. When Smarts is goaltending, well, it's painful. A 724 save percentage and 2.60 goals a game with a 12-10 record. I mean, this guy's had some weak, weak games. Weak. There were games where he's only faced 6 shots and he gave up, what, 4 or 5 goals? I'd have to look up the stats. I'm not trying to dig too deep here. I'm just saying, you guys in Pittsburgh, whether it be management or the players, need to step up and start performing. Like, we all have gotten accustomed to you performing. I mean, the beginning of the season, Smirky was defending you guys, saying that this is the most talented team he's ever seen. Anger management classes. That's 3 times now. The next time I'm going to swear it on my helmet. Yeah. Anyways, I hope you guys right the ship. I really, really do. Since we're in the East, the Boston Bruins. Or are they in ruins? You be the judge. The Boston Bruins right now are struggling. And I mean extremely struggling. They've made some moves and some roster adjustments, trying to find some chemistry that at one point during the week they could be just on fire and brilliant and putting up goals like nobody's business. And then there's other games where they couldn't buy a goal. End up being like a team full of plumbers. Nothing but pipe. I'm not knocking on you, Bruins. I'm rooting for you. I really am. But you guys are sitting in what? 10th? 11th? You're in 11th place with 30 points. Only 7 points back from 8th. So you're still within grenade range, as Haji would say. Gotta love Haji. We'll get to him in a second. I think you can turn the season around. I think all you need to do is put some winning streaks together. It doesn't have to be a winning streak, just a winning week. 6-3, 7-2, they start piling up, you start gaining points, and you're going to start playing teams in your division who you are competing with for a playoff spot. I'm talking about Montreal, I'm talking about Toronto. The busty saves, on the other hand, they might be too large for you to handle. But you can still stifle that team too. Don't give up hope. You're not in ruined yet. Speaking of Eastern Conference teams, and talking about Haji, the Washington Capitals, or as some would call them, a Washington? The Washington Capitals made an eye-opening, and quite frankly, a very bold trade last week, when they sent over to the Philadelphia Flyers, Eli, Newfie Miller, and that's Mr. Haji, for Giroux, Koster, and Oil City Legacy. Koster has been reunited back with the Washington Capitals. Koster was a vital part in last season's upset victory over the Boston Bruins in the first round and almost beat the Pittsburgh Penguins in round 2. Took it all the way to 7. However, the price you paid for Koster, I'm thinking of a word that starts with the letter R and rhymes with ape. Put it together. Let's move on to the West, shall we? How about we start things off with the defending Stanley Cup champs, otherwise known as the defending Stanley Cup chumps. Yes, that's right, the Columbus Blue Jackets. Last year's Cinderella story that overcame the odds and defeated the almighty $2 and Dollar Vision in a 7-game epic series to take home Lord Stanley's Cup. Unfortunately, can you say inconsistency? This team is very inconsistent. You go on a losing streak, start out the season 0-8, 0-5, whatever, you know, they're 1-8, 2-8. No big deal. Same thing happened last season. It's a long season. But then they start racking up the losses. Then they get a couple wins here and a couple wins there, but then they go right back on their faces with another huge loss. How about the French superstar, Hollywood? You remember the French superstar, last year's contender for Rookie of the Year. Very outspoken. Quite funny to be on the radio, actually. Hollywood, you're a plus one. In comparison, Donnie, I believe, is a plus 12, plus 11? I have to look that up. But he's higher than you. You did make that argument last season that your plus minus was better than his IQ. Which no one's debating. Don't Don't get me wrong, I like Donnie. I think Donnie's a great guy, but we'll get to him in a second. Hollywood, the French superstar, has 26 goals and 10 assists, 36 points, but is a plus one. Can you see the problem here? Inconsistencies. You can blow out teams, but you can also get your ass spanked. In fact, you were a minus nine in one game. A minus nine in the regular season. How does that happen? You're supposed to be the French superstar. Now, I'm not just singling you out, Hollywood. It's not all your fault. You're doing your part. You're scoring 26 goals and got 10 assists. Just inconsistent play. And inconsistent play, I'm talking about Kilowatt. Yeah, that's right. The New Jersey Shore loving goalie, Kilowatt. $12.5 million for a guy that has a .724 save percentage and a 3.40 goals against average. I think someone's watching a little too much Jersey Shore and not enough game film. This guy is the epitome of the words inconsistency. Look it up. I mean, we already know the guy doesn't play on Thursdays. But on a bright note, I do want to say I'm a big fan of their assistant GM, Hockey Gal, otherwise known as Chelsea. I am saddened to report that she is... Well, I'm not really saddened. I'm happy to report that she is finally out of the hospital. Turns out that she was viciously attacked by Darth Goomberg. I mean, he jumped her. I mean, he went Bertuzzi on her. She put up a hell of a fight. She really did. She stood her ground, didn't back away, didn't cower, didn't turtle. But she did get a couple scratches, and I think he pulled her hair, too. Freaking Goonberg. He is a goon. I mean, just show the clip. Painful to watch, I tell you. Anyways, she's out of the hospital, she's fully recovered, and she went to go see a dentist that Donnie recommended. She is back to her beautiful smile. And don't let her good looks fool you, folks. She'll poke the living shit out of you, poke check you, like crazy. She'll even hit you, and she'll also fight. She's not just your average girly defenseman, as Haji would call them, the poke checking pussy. No, she's not. She's a cerebral assassin. She'll lull you into thinking that she's going to poke check and then she'll knock your mouth just right off. She'll knock you off your skates. Be careful with her. She's feisty. Of course, Goomberg's got a black eye that she gave him. Nice shiner, by the way. I like the right-hand hook. Now, since we're still covering teams in the West, and this is my first show back in a while, I thought I'd give you an update on the old Donnie shooting his mouth off bit. You all remember this statement that he will more than double the victories in Nashville this season compared to last season. Let me refresh your memory. Nashville had 14 wins all of last season. 14. Double that would be 28. More than double that would be 29. There's your arithmetic lesson for the week. Donnie, your magic number's at 12. You guys have 17 victories. That's 3 more victories than all of last season's total for Nashville. That's right, 17. Unfortunately for your team, you're named the Nashville Predators, but you've become the VHL Prey. It seems like every team is bringing their top dog against yours. You're on a 5-game losing streak. Losing streak. Something needs to be done if you want to get that, avoid the date with the tattoo artist from South Carolina. Yeah. I have faith in it. The numbers are with you. You only have to average, not including this week, you only have to average 3 victories a week from here on out. 3. And you will crush the 29 win mark. 3. Can you do it? I think you can. I think you have the talent to do it. Problem is, I don't know if the talent on your team has the heart. That's right, I'm calling your whole team out. Heart. Determination, dedication, show some. 5-game losing streak, you come out of the gate just on fire in preseason, and now you guys are dead last in your division? Come on. You're the Predators, not the Prey. And finally, Ottawa. Wait. Ottawa what? Ottawa's on a two-game win. This can't be right. Ottawa's on a... Ottawa, what the hell? You're on a two-game winning streak, Ottawa. You beat the busty Sabres 4-3 in overtime last night in Game 1 of your home-and-home series. In Game 2, quite augmented, by the way, you beat them 5-1. An absolute thrashing! You beat the Sabres 5-1. Now, earlier this week, I was talking to one Tanaka, AT43, great guy. Stand-up character, and we were talking a little bit about puck, and he said he was kind of worried about the Ottawa matchup, and I said to him, I go, I can understand why you're worried. Don't let Ottawa's record fool you. They aren't a pushover. They aren't. They're not going to give up. The guys that are on that team want to win. They're not going to make the playoffs. Don't get me wrong, Ottawa fans. I'm not bashing you at all. I'm just saying that bad luck, bad strings, bad stretch, here and there, blah, 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 you name it, it happened. You guys are still there, and you're still putting an effort on the ice. You're still putting guys together to go play and drive it to the other team and show them that you're not the pushovers. And it shows with a 4-3 victory over the busty Sabres, who's leading the division and should just, no offense, statistically on paper crush you if you go by records and only records. And then you come back and smack them in the mouth again, pour a little salt in the wound, 5-1. As I was talking to Tanaka this week, I said, be careful of this Ottawa team, because if you guys lose game one, you're probably going to lose game two. He shared my concerns. He said, yes, it would be extremely dangerous if we lose the first game, no matter how close it is. Ottawa's going to come back with a vengeance in game two, and it's a whole new animal. Ottawa. Seriously. I'm a fan. Ottawa Senators. It was said on the radio that you guys could win 12 games this season, and it would be a milestone. Not really a milestone, but it would be a hell of an achievement for a team that's been down in the dumps for the first half of the season. You're on your first winning streak, a legitimate winning streak, beating a top-notch team. I'm a fan. I'm a huge fan. Go to it, guys. I hope you guys get on the ice and show every single team in this league that no matter how bad things are, no matter how bad things may seem, you still go out there with the fire, the determination, and the desire to show other teams that you mean business. You may not make the playoffs this season, but you guys are going to do exactly what the New York Rangers did last season. And that is, go from shitty to top. I mean, you come from the bowels of the VHL. I mean, bottom of the trash heap. Seriously, no offense, New York, but you were. And then you come out of the ashes, make the playoffs, and hopefully make a push. Go out there and continue to play the hockey that you guys are playing right now. I swear to God, you're going to have more fans. I'm one of them. Go get them, Ottawa. That's it for us here at the Penalty Box. For Max, my cat, and everybody else here at the Penalty Box Studio, we'll see you at Center Ice when the puck drops. And Ottawa, I'm watching. I'm a huge fan now. Come on, Ottawa. Let's see if the winning streak continues. We'll see you at Center Ice when the puck drops. Oh, I almost forgot. We're going to leave you guys tonight instead of the traditional puck drop. Nah, thought I'd do something else. The Call of the Season. By that announcer guy, what's his name, who seems to have a problem with coffee cups. Enjoy. We're out of here. Let's go watch that Ottawa game. Yeah!
Clears it. I don't know where he is. Here we go, across the blue line. Here the Bears. Throw on to him. The Bears turn up. Back to the point. That's not the point. That's the fucking, whatever that thing is in the middle of the ice. Here we go. Here the Bears. The Bears wrapping around. Great save made by the Arrow. Uh-oh, 2-on-1 back the other way for the Arrows. Shot! Scores! What a goal! Scored by number 28. What a shot. Roost it. 1-0 for the Arrows. spilled coffee!